Hey guys, welcome to SourceFED. I'm Joe Beretta.
Steve Zaragoza.
And we're best friends.
Yeah!
Best friends, Joe and Steve, we're best friends. If you are still with us, we'll have a space story after this intro. After embarking on a 10-year-long, very lonely space vision quest and traveling 4 billion miles, a human-made piece of machinery has finally reached its destination. A comet dubbed 67P, Churyumov Gerasimenko.
Nailed it. The spacecraft called Rosetta will not teach the comet Spanish, but it will orbit the 2.5-mile-wide comet, the first spacecraft to do such a thing, and later on, it will attempt to plop out and land a probe on the surface of the comet. Thank you for the diagram, Joe.
The spacecraft's future probe baby will be called Fillet, and due to the fact that the comet retains a very weak gravitational field, the probe baby will shoot out probe baby harpoons that will latch onto 67P and anchor it to the surface so it doesn't become a free-floating George Clooney. Spoiler alert.
No, Joe, you're supposed to say spoiler alert before you provide the spoiler.
Oh.
You're welcome.
No, you're supposed to say, like, I'm sorry. You're welcome is definitely not what I want to say.
Okay, like and subscribe.
Okay, no, the story's not over.
Okay.
Wow, Joe, Jesus. Anyways, the landing might be a little more difficult than scientists from the European Space Agency originally thought back in 2004, because the comet looks like this.
It looks like God's jazzercise dumbbell. Right now, the spaceship is studying the terrain and magnetic field, and when the 220-pound probe touches down, it will drill down 8 inches and collect samples for analyzation. All the while, both the spaceship and probe will be taking and sending back pictures. Like space selfies and stuff.
Spelfies? Spaceys.
Nope, moving on.
Once the travel buddies eventually pass by the sun on their road trip, the comet will start to spew gas from its outer layer that boiled off due to the intense heat from our light ball. And the instruments will study the comet's dust trail to see if comets might have been capable of bringing water to our planet way back in the day.
Matt Taylor, one of the project scientists, said, "The reason we look at comets is that they were right there at the beginning. Learning about them gives us an idea of where Earth came from and where the whole solar system came from. What the primordial material at the beginning of the solar system was made up of." Bruce Willis dies on the asteroid at the end. Spoiler alert.
Joe, Christ, come on, man. Jeez. Sick of it. Stop spoiling stuff.
Thought I was doing it right.
Guys, what space thing would you want scientists to send a ship to for further advancement of our knowledge? Let us know down below.
Wait, Steve, I got it now. Spoiler alert. Sunshine is like the best space movie ever.
Joe, that's not technically a spoiler alert. It's an opinion. And a damn good one at that.